Wow, we were supposed to get $600 stimulus checks next week. And overnight, the president tweeted and changed everything. Hey guys, it's Hamza, and in today's video, I'm gonna be talking about the update that we received on the stimulus checks. So just yesterday, I uploaded a video on when you guys should be expecting your $600 stimulus checks and how to apply for them if you haven't done so already. And I decided to take a little break from watching media and monitoring the situation since we thought that the bill had completely passed, and bam, the president comes out and tweets and vetoes the entire situation. A couple of things that we have to understand is that this was a bill that was negotiated by the Democrats and the Republicans together. And it took months to come to this agreement where we thought we were getting stimulus next week. I mean, Mnuchin said that the checks were going to come out between tomorrow and January 15th, but now everything has changed. Everything's back on the table, and the president's tweet was very elaborate, and we actually got to find out that there's a lot of stuff in the stimulus bill that is not actually stimulus for the American economy. Based on President Trump's video posted on Twitter by him yesterday, it shows exactly where the money was going and how many billions of dollars is going to international countries. Now, I found that interesting because, of course, as you all know, the bill is actually 5,598 pages long. And it seems like, on the surface, all the American people are going to receive is $600. He did leave out the part which is most relevant to me and to you guys as real estate investors or potential real estate investors, which was the $25 billion allocated towards the rental assistance program, which I thought was a complete joke. I don't think $25 billion is going to be enough for the rental assistance program. And I think that number needs to be at least triple that. Now, with this veto, we may actually see an increase in that rental assistance program, which is great news for all of you people who are interested in investing in real estate. What this means is that the tenants now will be able to use this rental assistance program funding and pay us or pay the landlords their dues until the vaccine is completely out and things slowly start to normalize. Let's get back to the stimulus and the $600 that we talked about yesterday. So it seems like Pelosi is now siding with Trump. She actually retweeted his tweet where he said that he wants $2,000 stimulus for every single person and $4,000 for each family. Now, if you really think about it, it took so long to agree on the $600 that people were actually starting to look forward to the $600. But I think everybody wouldn't mind waiting if that number suddenly changed to $2,000 per person. Hell, I know if I qualified, I definitely wouldn't have minded waiting a few more days to get $2,000 instead of $600. But here are the facts. The facts are that we were supposed to receive funding next week, and now, because it's the holidays, right? It's December 23rd today when I'm shooting this video. So obviously on the 24th and 25th, nothing's happening. Most likely, I think things are gonna start getting back on track starting January, which means we're gonna have another round of negotiations, and I don't know how long that's gonna take. And I'm just looking at this from a factual standpoint. The fact that it took us this long to bring stimulus, $600, to the people, in my mind, only says that there's gonna be further delays to get the $2,000 check that President Trump vetoed for. Now, another thing I wanted to inform you guys of, because there's a little bit of confusion around it, is that people who do not have a social security number will not be allocated a stimulus, but their families who have valid social security IDs will. So for example, if you have one person in the family who has an ITIN number, but everybody else has a social security number, everybody else will still get this stimulus. So you will have families that may have illegal aliens that are still receiving stimulus. But this is not to be confused with illegal aliens getting stimulus directly. In fact, the bill clearly says that anyone with an ITIN number will not be receiving stimulus. I just put that little part in there to settle any confusion that there is around illegal aliens getting stimulus. As of right now, there is nothing in that bill that allows an illegal alien to receive stimulus checks. So whether it's $600 or $2,000, you do need a social security number or valid presence in the United States. It looks like the president is going to go out with the same energy that he came in with. And by pulling this last minute stunt, it's gonna attract a lot of media attention, which we all know President Donald Trump absolutely loves. And somehow, if the president was able to pass this $2,000 stimulus check per individual, this will be his legacy stimulus. And if he chooses to run in 2024, which I really think he will, this legacy is going to be very vital for that election. So it's really weird that we're caught in all of this politics while the people still have not received their stimulus checks. And the economy as a whole, I feel like, has been on a hold for quite a while. I feel like the timing for everything, the COVID vaccine, the elections, the stimulus, is all somehow intertwined with each other. And the only people losing out are the people who really need that stimulus money. As of right now, things are very confusing. We really don't know in which direction the stimulus check is gonna go. This is all the information I have for right now. I'm gonna keep you guys updated as soon as I have more information on the stimulus check. Once again, my name is Hamza, and I'll see you guys next video.